how gate problems are solved. At first we will take 1 mark problem, then we will take 2 mark problem. Here I have taken one problem which is asked in gate 2014. Now the problem is the root locus of unity feedback system is shown in figure. The root locus of unity feedback system is shown in figure. The closed loop transfer function of system is, there are 4 options. First is KYS plus 1, these are the 4 options. Now how to solve? Clearly you can see from the root locus plot there are 2 poles. How I am saying there are 2 poles? Because there are 2 crosses also at the point of cross K, the value of K is 0. So there are 2 poles. So there are 2 open loop poles. Then what will be the open loop transfer function for this system? The OLTF. Now the OLTF, open loop transfer function for this particular system will be K divided by S plus 1 multiplied by S plus 2. There is no 0, that's why I have not taken anything in the numerator. Now for what the OLTF stands? OLTF is nothing but this is GS multiplied by HS. GS multiplied by HS. Now what is they are asking closed loop transfer function. So what will be the closed loop transfer function? CLTF, closed loop transfer function. This will be equal to GS divided by, or you can say one plus GS into HS. Here one more thing is to be marked, the root locus of unity feedback system. So here HS, here this HS is nothing but this is equal to 1. So it is equal to GS only. So what will be the value of closed loop transfer function? Obviously it will be K divided by S plus 1 into S plus 2 divided by 1 plus K divided by S plus 1 into S plus 2, and that will give its value as K divided by S plus 1 into S plus 2 plus K. So this must be the answer. This should be the answer. So our answer will be this D. So our answer is D. Now let us. So now the second question is, figure shows the root locus plot, location of poles not given, of a third order system whose OLTF is, OLTF means open loop transfer, whose OLTF is, here the problem is given, the root locus is given, and the problem asks about the open loop transfer function. What will be the open loop transfer function? There are 4 options. First is K by S cube, second is K by S cube multiplied by S plus 3, K by S into S square plus 1, K by S into S square minus 1. Obviously, at first, what is the order of the system? Order of the system is third order. So, obviously, answer B, it is not possible, because in answer B, it is a fourth order system. So now we have to see what will be the answer from A, C and D. Now what we see, Here we see that there are two branches, or you can say there are, here we can see that there are three branches, and all branches of root locus are going in, are going towards infinity, or you can say they are terminating at infinity. And what is the angle? What is this angle? This angle. What is this angle? Actually, this angle is nothing but, this angle is tan inverse root 3, and that is nothing but 60 degree. Obviously, it is 60 degree, then this angle is nothing but, this is 300 degree, because this branch is symmetrical, actually root locus is symmetrical about real axis. So it is at 60 degree, then it will be at 360 degree. So this is at 360 degree, and this one is at 180 degree. So this angle is, this angle is 60 degree, another one, this angle is 180 degree, 180 degree, and this angle, you can say this is 300 degree. Again, from this root locus, one thing could be marked that this root locus doesn't contain any zero. Why I am saying this? Because all roots are terminating at infinity. So there are only poles. So there are only poles. Again, these root locus are originating from origin, that is s equal to 0. Again, we have to mark, let me write one by one. At first point is root locus doesn't contain any zero, any open loop zero. Because all root locus, all branches are terminating at infinity. This is the first point. Second point is, all branches are starting from s equal to 0. All branches are starting from s equal to 0. So when it is possible, it is only possible if one more thing is given, that this is a third order system. One more thing is given, that this is a third order system. So obviously there are three poles. Third order system is three poles, and all poles must be at origin, because all branches are starting from origin. So the root, the OLTF may be GS into HS equal to k by s cube. It may be. Now it now you can verify, you can also verify this from the root locus. So because all the branches of root locus are originating from origin s equal to 0, and first one is going towards going towards infinity at an angle 60 degree. This can be also verified from what will be the asymptote, direction of asymptote. So asymptotes are given by what? Phi A equal to 180 multiplied by 2q plus 1 divided by n minus 1, where q equal to 0, 1, 2, because here q will be varying from 0 to 2. Why it will be varying from 0 to 2? Because there are only 3 poles. Here n is number of poles. This is nothing but number of poles. And this is nothing but number of zeros. But there are no zero, because all branches are terminating at infinity. So we can write here 180 degree into 2q plus 1 divided by 3. So 60 into 2q plus 1. Now if you give the value of q as 0, then it will come 60 degree. If you give the value of q as 1, then it will come 180 degree. If you give the value of q as 2, then it will come 300 degree. So it and here also we see what is the value of what is the value of angle towards which the root locus is going, that is 60 degree, 180 degree and 300 degree. So this our prediction is correct, and this OLTF is the correct OLTF. Means this will be the correct answer. So what should be the answer? This is the answer. A. Now the third problem is, which of the following figures represent valid root loci in the S-plane for positive k? Assume that the system has transfer function with real coefficients. So at first, this cannot be root locus. Why? Because root locus is symmetrical about real axis. So this case is not possible. Now three cases left: A, B, and D. In this case, there are two poles here and two poles here, means four poles. And in this case also, root locus is existing on this axis, because arrow is here, because an arrow is coming, means the root locus is existing. And what the rule says, those part of real axis right to which total number of poles and zeros are in odd number are part of root locus. But here right to this part, the total number of poles and zeros are 2, which is even number. So this is also not, means this is also
not valid root process.
Now, what about
this?
Now, what about
this?
So, here, here also we see there is no arrow, nothing is clear, and where root is going, so this is also not possible. What about this case? Here there are two poles, here there are two poles and two zeros, and root locus are starting from one pole in this direction and from another point in this direction, and this is the breakaway point, and after breaking from this point, root locus goes to 1 0, one part of root locus goes to 1 0 and another part of root locus goes to 1 0. So this could be a valid, means this is a valid answer. This is a valid root locus. So answer is correct. Now, so let me discuss about the fourth problem. Here, a unity feedback system has an open loop transfer function of the form Ks equal to K divided by K multiplied by S plus A divided by S square into S plus B, where B is greater than A. Now there are four options. So which one will be the correct root? Here option C cannot be a correct root locus. Why it cannot be a correct root locus? Because suppose here at first, see, there are two poles at origin and one pole at minus B. So two poles at origin and one pole at minus B. So two branches will originate from here. In each case, two branches will originate from here. So in each case, two branches will originate from here. Okay. But what happens? Two branches will originate. Okay, that is okay. But this is not a root locus. Why I am saying this is not a root locus? Because this, suppose one branch is going in this direction, another branch is going in this direction, then they break away and one is getting its terminating point at minus A, but another will go in this direction. But here arrow shows that this is moving towards this direction, so it is not a valid root locus. Another is so A, B or D. So the option left is A, B and D. So what about A? Here also in each case branches, one branch is originating from a pole at minus B and terminating at minus A. Here also. But the difference is in other two branches. Here other two branches in left half of this plane, here some part of that branch is in right half of this plane, and here entire part of rest two branches are in right half of this plane. So let us see which one is the correct answer. So at first, what will be the centroid? So centroid minus sigma A, that is calculated by sigma real part of poles minus sigma real part of zeros divided by n minus m. So what is the real part of poles? Here real part of poles, here two poles have real part 0, but here real part of pole is minus 1. What about real part of zeros? There is only one zero, so real part of 0 is at minus a. So minus minus a divided by n minus m. N, what is n? N is the total number of poles, that is 3, and m is the total number of zeros. So 3 minus 1. So minus b plus a divided by 2. Again it is given that b is greater than. So minus b plus a, that will be a negative quantity. So this is less than 0. So asymptote will definitely lies. Suppose I draw sigma, this is j omega axis. So suppose this will, the asymptote will be here. So asymptote will be, how the asymptote will be? This will be the asymptote. This will be the asymptote. So what the theory says, the principle says, the two branches of root locus will terminate at infinity along asymptote. So they will originate from here but terminate along this. Means that must be in this direction only. In this direction only. So here, in this case, there is no direction, it is directionless. Here it is moving in right direction, in right half face plane. So only valid answer is this one, A. So this is the only valid answer. This is the